Hey guys, welcome to Arihant Online Academy. In this video, we will solve the question number 21st to 30 for the July 2018 UGC NET CS paper 2. The previous 20 questions we have already solved and the video are already uploaded, and the next question we will solve as early as possible and we will upload their video soon, right? So guys, kind subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon button so that you can't miss any of the important videos from our site, and you can score more by observing this kind of questions and analyze them, right? So let's start. The question number 21st that was asked in July 2018 paper 2 was, which of the following statement is true? Basically it was question 20, and the 21st question we have discussed on the place of 20 question, okay? So don't confuse with that, right? The statement P is refactoring is the process of changing a software system in such a way that it does not alter the external behavior of the code yet improves the internal architecture. So it is a true statement that the refactoring is the process where software system changes in such a way that it does not alter or affect the external behavior of the code, but it improves the internal architecture, right? So this is the refactoring. And an example of refactoring is adding new feature to satisfy a customer requirement is covered after a project is shipped. So it is not a universally true statement. Okay, so only statement P, only answer A is the correct. Option A is the right answer. Now the next question is, consider the array A 4, 1, 3, 2, 16, 9, 10, 14, 8, 7. After building heap from the array A, the depth of the heap and right child of the max heap are fill in the blanks. So we have to fill in the blanks the depth of the heap and the right child of the max heap, okay? And the root is at level 0 is given, right? So basically we have to solve this question by making a almost completely binary tree, and we have to heapify that, right? So I have solved this. Firstly, array of 10 numbers is given to us, right? 4, 1, 3, 2, 16, 9, 10, 14, 8 and 7. So we will firstly make almost binary complete tree or complete tree, whatever possible from it, right? After that, we have to heapify that. So what is the process of heapify? We will upload a video lecture of that so that you can understand there well. Here you can understand that after heapifying, the building heap will be made like that. The maximum element would be at the root place, then 14 would be there, it is the maximum from this subtree, and similarly here is right, here is 10, it is the maximum from this subtree, similarly here 8, it is the maximum from this subtree, here is 7, which is maximum from this subtree, and the leaf elements are always heapified, means leaf elements are always follows the property of heap algorithm, right? So basically the depth of the algorithm, you can easily observe that 3, because root element is given as the root element is at the level 0 or at the depth 0, so the total depth is 3, and the right element of the max heap, so max heap is here 16 and the right element of here is 10, right? So how to solve this heap we will discuss in our algorithm part, right? Because if you will want to learn this video, then it will take some half an hour like that, so we will upload a separate video for that, right? So the correct answer here is 3 and 10 P. Now the next question is, a hash function H defined H key is equals to key mode H. Here a hash function is given to us, H key is equals to key mode 7, with linear probing is used to insert the keys 44, 45, 79, 55, 91, 18 and 63 into table index from 0 to 6. What will be the location of key 18? What will be the location of key 18, right? So I have solved this question by using the function of linear probing in hash. The function is given to us that H key is equals to key mode 7. So if we have to divide any key with modulus 7, then we either get remainder as 0 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6, right? So we have make 6 places data structure here. After that, keys given to us are 44, 45, 79, 55, 91, 18 and 63. And we have been asked that on which place this 18 would be placed, right? So first we have solved 44 key, right? In sequence wise, 44 modulus 7, key modulus 1. On the place of key, you have to place this key 44, then modulus 7. You will get modulus as 2. So on the place of 2, you will place this key, that is 44. After that, you will take key 45. On moduling 45 via 7, you will get 3. So you will place 45 on the place 3, index 3. 45 is placed. Similarly, on solving 79, you have got 79 mod 7 as a 2. But on the place 2, there is already 45. So linear probing will be there. Linear probing means it will goes to next place. Here already element is there, so it will again goes to the next place, and 79 would be placed here because here is blank space, right? So 79 would be placed here. Now the next key is 55 now, because this is done, this is done, this is done. Now 55 is there. 55 modulus 7, you will get 6 as a modulus. So you will go on to the 6 index 7 and place the 55 there, right? After that, the key is 91. This 55 is completed. After that, 91 is there. On 91 modulus 7, you will get remainder 0. So on the index 0, you will put 91. Now the key 18 is there, which we have to put. Okay, this 91 we have solved. Now this 18, where will it will be placed, right? So 18 modulus 7, when you will solve 18 modulus 7, you will get 4 as a remainder. So 4, on the place of 4, there is already 79 is existing, right? So we will linear probe to the next place, which is blank. So 18 will be placed on the index 5, right? So on the index 5, we will place the element 18. So the correct answer is 5th, right? So I hope you have understood all this concept of hashing, and let's discuss the next question. The next question says, which of the following algorithms solve the single source shortest path? So there are 4 algorithms are given: Prim's algorithm, Floyd-Warshall algorithm, Johnson's algorithm, and Dijkstra's algorithm. So basically, Dijkstra's algorithm is also known as single source shortest path, right? So option 4 is the right answer. The next question is, a text is made up of the characters A, B, C, D, E, each occurring with the probability of 0.08, 0.40, 0.25, 0.15, and 0.12 respectively, right? And we have asked that the optimal coding technique will have the average length of. So we have to use optimal coding technique here, and we have to find average length, right? So I have solved this question via using optimal coding technique, in which we have to sum all the characters probability 0.08 plus 0.40, this value of C 0.25, 0.15, and 0.12. So I get the value 1, right? This 1 would be the root element. This 1 would be get with root element, right? Now after that, what I have done, the optimal coding technique says that the maximum element of all the existing probability would be placed, right? So what is the maximum? First B, it is the maximum value, right? So 0.40, subtract the 0.40 from this, so you will get 0.60. now place the smallest element into the left side and greater element onto the right side. So after subtracting the value of B, that is 0.40, you will get 0.60 also. So we have to place 0.40, that is the value of B, on the left side as it is small, and the value of 0.60, which is the remaining sum from the 1, would be placed on the right place, right? Now the second step says that after completing this, the second highest value is what is the second highest value? So you will observe that this 20.25 is the second highest value. So we have to subtract this 0.25 from this 0.60. So you will get 0.35. Now this 0.35 and 0.25 is there. 0.25 is the small. So 0.25 we will place on the left side, and 0.35 the remaining sum will be placed on the right side. And we will assign the name of 0.25C as it is given in the question here, right? After 0.35, the next highest value is D, that is 0.15. After subtracting 0.35, 0.15 from 0.35, we will get 0.20 as a remainder, right? So 0.15 would be similarly placed on the left side as it is smaller, and 0.20, the remaining sum, would be placed on the right side as it is greater than 0.15, right? Now the remaining sum, the highest key that remains after this 3 is E, that is 0.12. So 0.12 and 0.8, right? Only two keys is left. So 0.12 is highest, that is the value of E would be placed on the right, and value of A, that is 0.08, would be placed on the left side because it is smaller than the value of E, right? Now what we have to do now, all the edges which have the left sign, all the edges which are going to the left side, we have to assign the value 0 to them, like 0 on the left side. This left side also assign the value 0, this left side also assign the value 0, and this left side also assign the value 0. And all the edges which are going on right side will be assigned the value 1. This is also going right side 1, right side 1, right side 1. Means we have to assign all the right side edges as a 1, and we have to assign all the left side edges as a 0. Now we have to find average length, right? So for average length, we have to find value of A. What is the optimal chord of A? Optimal chord of A is here, right? So to reach from root to A, we have to traverse like 1, 1, 1, 0. So after traversing by this root 1, 1, 1, 0, we have reached at A. So the optimal chord of A is 1, 1, 1, 0. As there are 4 bits, so 4 will be multiplied with the probability of A, that is 0.08, we will get 0.32. What we have done, we have just traversed the path through which we will reach to A via from root element. So we will reach to A node via root element via traversing 1110. So this is the optimal chord of 1, as it consists of the 4 bits. So we will multiply 4 with the value of A, that is the probability of A is given, or the value of A is 0.08, so we will get 0.32. Similarly, we will get the value of B. To reach B from the root, we just have to traverse 0. So 0 is the optimal chord of B, and as it is only 1 bit, so we will multiply 1 with the value of B, that is 0.40, we will get 0.40. Similarly, to reach C from the root element, we have to traverse via path 1,0. So after traversing via 1,0, we will get 1 and 0, 2 bits. So we will multiply 2 with the value of C, that is 20.25. We will get 0.50 as the answer. Now after this, we will have to traverse D, 1,1,0. So as it is consist of 3 bits, so the 3 will be multiplied with the value D, so we will have value of it as a 0.45, and we have to finally reach the value E, that is 1111, and after traversing like 1111 from root, we will reach up to E. So the optimal code of E is 1111, and as it consists of 4 bits, so we will multiply 4 with the value of E, that is 0.12. So we will get 0.12 multiplied with 4.48. Now in question, we have asked the average length. So in this case, average length would be the sum of this all 5 chords, 0.32 point plus 0.40 plus 0.50 plus 0.45 plus 0.48. So we will get 2.15 is the right answer. Option 4 is the right answer. The next question is, a binary search tree in which every non-leaf node has non-empty left and right subtree is called a strictly binary tree. So strictly binary tree is the tree in which all the non-leaf parent strictly have 2 children. Either it doesn't have any children, or if it has children, then they should consist of 2 children. For example, this is a strictly binary tree, but this is not a strictly binary tree. Why? Because this root only consists one child, but strictly binary tree should consist 2 child, right? So this is a strictly binary tree, but this is not a strictly binary tree. Even though this is a strictly binary tree because it doesn't contain any child, this is okay, but this is not okay, right? So we have asked that in a binary tree in which every non-leaf node, this is leaf node which doesn't have any child, and this is non-leaf node which have child. So every non-leaf node has non-empty left and right subtree called strictly binary tree. Such a tree with 19 leaves. So if a strictly binary tree has 19 leaves, then how many total nodes should be there? So you can design yourself as a tree, because every time you will design a tree in which total 19 leaves are there, like one first leaf, second leaf, third leaf, fourth leaf, fifth leaf, six, seven, and up to 19 leaves are there, right? You can also design any kind of leaf. Suppose you have extend this and you can make any 19 leaves. Okay, so every time you will make a strictly binary tree in which you consist of 19 leaves, so total nodes will be 37, right? So total leaf nodes is there 19 in strictly binary tree. It may possible that your structure of binary tree would be different, right? But every time total node would be at most exactly 37, right? So answer B is the correct answer. It has exactly 37 nodes. Now the next question is, we have to match the list 1 with list 2. So this is easiest question, the 8 queen problem. So the 8 queen problem is backtracking problem. Single source shortest path. So single source shortest path theorem, that is Dijkstra's theorem, it follows greedy approach. Stressens matrix. So Stressens matrix, if you have solved, it is divide and conquer method. And optimal binary search tree are dynamic programming. So 1 with 4, A with 4 means option 3rd is out of answer. Option B 3 means option A is also not right answer. Option C, the right answer option C is 2. So option 4th is the right answer, right? And D ka 1, right? So this is the correct match of list 1 with list 2. Now the next question is, the maximum number of comparisons needed to sort 9 items using radix sort, right? So basically we have assumed that each item has 5 digital octal numbers. So basically octal numbers are there which uses 0 to 7 digits, any digits including 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So total 8 digits are there, right? In octal system we use 0 to 7 numbers, right? Now the octal number system, or OCT for short, is the base 8 number system and uses digit 0 to 7. Now we have to find maximum number of comparison which are needed to sort 9 items using radix sort. Okay, so 9 items is there, multiply it with total number of digits which can be possible in octal number, which is 0 to 7, means total number of digits possible here is 8, and 5 digit octal number is there, right? So multiply with 5, so you will get 360, means option 3 is the right answer. Now the next question is 25. Actually this question is ambiguity in the question, and after exam when revised keys are generated by UGC net, this question is contains ambiguity. So all the candidates who have attempted this question will be given a bonus 2 marks for this, right? Because this question doesn't have any right answer, the question contains ambiguity in itself, so we are leaving this question, right? The next question is, considering a boolean function of n variables, the order of an algorithm that determines whether the boolean function produces a output 1 is. So basically if you will solve the solution, na, boolean algebra either consists 0 or 1. 0 means false, 1 means true. Now total variables are given us as n variable, and we have to find the order of algorithm which will determine whether the boolean function is produces output 1, right? So the order to find 1 is 2 to the power n, because the total variables are n, it means that the truth table will consist of 2 to the power n rows, right? It means that the order is exponential, 2 to the power n is exponential, right? So option D is the right answer here. So I hope you have understood all the solutions which I have discussed with you. Further, if you have any kind of queries or doubt, you can comment here so that I can solve your query as early as possible. So please like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon button so that in our upcoming lectures, whenever we will upload next videos and important topics related UGC NET and all important exams, you can't miss any of them and you can analyze all the solutions of the remaining questions also and score more. Thank you so much guys. Have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.